Today is another one in our series of trying to break down the energy in our rooms so that we can better understand how it reacts. And if we can better understand how it reacts with our rooms, then obviously we can find the appropriate treatment for it, the one that works for our room usage. I find it's helpful to break the energy down into a room into two areas, waves and rays. Waves, just like the ocean waves, for purposes of this discussion, we'll call it any frequency below 100 cycles because they're longer wavelengths. So that would be, what, 11.3 or so feet, 100 cycle wave. So it's long. It may not fit into our room. If our room is 6 feet wide, obviously it's not going to fit. So any frequency below 100 cycles. And there, I want you to kind of think like ocean waves. More powerful, more forceful, more energy, obviously. What do they do, waves in our room? They don't fit most of the time, especially in our smaller project studios and smaller rooms today because real estate is so expensive. So room modes, we're all familiar with the problems that they cause, the blurring and the smearing with the excess pressure buildups in certain parts of the room. I also have a video on how you can locate room modes and where they are in your room and then how to treat them. SBIE, speaker boundary interference effect, it has its own name because it's so prominent. It's that area between your speaker and the closest room surface. That little area can cause issues. There can be pressure buildups there. There can be comb filtering with rays. These all produce sound. And the only thing we want producing sound is the speakers and our source. Obviously the room is going to contribute, but we need to know when the room is making its own sound and when the speaker is making its own sound. So by studying these different ideas and breakdowns, we can do that. Rays are much shorter wavelengths, smaller, greater than 100 cycles. They contribute to the reflections in our room. They also contribute to comb filtering, SPIE, and poor diffusion. Poor diffusion in smaller rooms is really important. We want to make our small room sound like a larger room without boundaries, without walls, without floors, without ceilings. And the only way we can do that is to have a room that's properly diffused. Different room purposes, live rooms, monitoring rooms, control rooms, all have different purposes. So they all need a little bit different approach at the mixing and monitoring and listening position. So by understanding how the energy breaks down into your room in just really two ways, waves and rays, it'll help us get a better understanding on how to treat these issues, because both take completely different treatment options. Thank you.